The center that is called Advanced Self-Power Systems of Integrated Sensors and Technologies is a National Science Foundation Nanosystems Engineering Research Center. And the focus of our center is to take advances in nanotechnologies that have happened over the last several years and apply them towards addressing the problem of global health. As you know, global health is one of the biggest challenges facing our future, and healthcare costs are staggering. And one of the ways to control and manage this process is to provide better information to the user and the doctor about an individual's health. And so we are seeking in our center to build hassle-free, comfortable, wearable health monitoring devices that provide the user with their personal health and also at the same time their personal environmental exposure. These systems, the unique feature of our center's devices are that they'll be self-powered. The self-powering will be coming from the human body in the form of heat or motion. And these self-powering devices will then provide long-term operation, which will then lead to higher compliance and long lifetime measurements of different health and environmental parameters. We expect that these devices will have a significant impact on global health because they will empower the patient and the doctor to transition from managing illness to managing wellness. NC State is leading this center, but we have strong strategic partnerships with several key institutions. One of them is Penn State University, and another one is University of Virginia. Then we're also partnering with Florida International University. And we also have faculty participation from institutions such as University of North Carolina at Chapel Hill and University of Michigan. We have partnerships with Korea Advanced Institute of Science and Technology. We're also working with Tokyo Institute of Technology and University of Adelaide. Industry is really our partner that we're going to work hand in hand to generate these technologies. In fact, in these types of centers that NSF funds, the involvement of industry is key. The wristband that we have in mind will allow one to monitor their physiological parameters, such as their heart rate, their oxygen levels in the blood, their respiration rate, along with monitoring environmental parameters such as ozone and carbon monoxide and things like that. And it'll allow one to directly correlate the environmental exposure to the personal health exposure. And all this is actually being done in a self-powered manner, which implies that there won't be any need for the user to change or charge the batteries. The system is automatically and continuously powered by the energy coming from the human body. And so this allows for long-term monitoring and allows for very high user compliance. Wireless communication is the main way that is the most desired way that information should be transmitted from the device to a local base station. And local base station, in our case, could be your iPhone or your cell phone. In our center, we have activities that we're working on that'll generate extremely low power wireless radios to transmit the information. I think in general, the education program that we are putting forth will create engineers that'll compete in the globally competitive society in the area of healthcare, and the intersection of engineering and biology, which is where the center resides, will allow us to create engineers that will really be the innovators in the future global health society.